teacher from Morogoro. My name is Chief Gaimo. I'm teaching English in Form 4. Now today, I want to share with you topic number 3, that is about reading literary works. In the previous sessions, I have started to analyze novels. And this novel, we are referring to the novel of Pasdi Laiki, A Shadow. I attempted to describe the title, I attempted to describe the setting, and I gave you the overview, or that means the general summary of the book. Today we have to, I have to share with you the summary of chapters. I have covered chapter number 1, chapter number 2, and chapter number 3. Now, let us start chapter number 4. Okay, if you remember, in chapter number 3, we have seen the character Vicky. Vicky is the Adieri's late sister's daughter. This girl Vicky was living with this family of Mr. Adieri just because her mother had passed away. Thereafter, this girl was committed a mistake. Therefore, she was chased away from Adieri's house. And what did she do? It's because she was seen riding a bicycle in town, something that is very contrary to the Batooro people, the village of Kachwamba. Girls are not allowed to ride bicycles. The implication that if you are seen riding a bicycle, it means you are an easygoing girl. Therefore, this girl was chased away from Adieri's house. Now, what happened? When Vicky came back, she came out, she came with a man called Akena, whose intention is to marry Vicky. But what happened is that Adieri demanded a large amount of bride price. The man, Mr. Akena, failed to pay that amount of bride price, and that marriage was broke. So what happened now? What happened to this family? Vicky is there. She was not allowed to get married just because the man failed to pay the bride price. Now, today in chapter 4, look at the pictures. This picture demonstrates women picking tea leaves. Now, try to relate this with what we are going to discuss in chapter number 4. Vicky, when the man failed to pay the bride price, Vicky was staying there, very idle. The wife of Mr. Adieri decided to send Vicky to Bundibugyo village so that she can go to pluck tea leaves. Thereafter, the money could be used to pay the school fees of her children. Now, Vicky was sent to Bundibugyo so that he can do that work, but the man was already paid. So what could happen to Vicky? She went to work, but no money. How could she survive? That is how Vicky was being treated in that family of her uncle. Since there was nobody to care for her, she's a girl that either she has grown up, she has some sort of needs, but nobody need to care for Vicky. So what happened? When she come back when she come back from Bundibugyo, where she went to pick tea leaves, she come home, but there was nothing she can do. Nobody caring her for her. What happened? She met her friends Tusiime and Kunihira. These are the age-mates of Vicky. And these girls have been expelled from school due to indiscipline cases. So when they meet Vicky, can you predict what would happen? They trying to convince Vicky, the girl who, you can say Vicky is an orphan because she doesn't have a mother nor a father. Now what could be happened to Vicky? Nobody was caring for her. When she met these friends, they were trying to convince Vicky so that she could engage in prostitution, something that could help her to earn her living. Now, let's see what happened. This girl, Vicky was afraid to get pregnant when she engaged in a prostitution, but also Vicky was afraid of who? Her uncle, who could be chase her when he discovered that Vicky was engaging in bad behavior. But these children, they seem to know this family very much. They said that, fear not, your uncle whom you are afraid of, the man doesn't respect himself. As the headmaster of St. Leo's High School, the man was dismissed from the school, a church-only school, was dismissed simply because he engaged in love affairs with another employee. Thereafter, he was dismissed from the work. And also, at the same time, the man was caught having a financial scandal. That we say that this man doesn't respect himself. So why are you bother to fear him? So you can do anything you want. For the case of pregnancy, Vicky, don't be afraid of getting pregnant. It's because if you take care very much, for example, using contraceptive, you can avoid getting pregnant. And when you engage in prostitution, Vicky, you will get money that could help you to solve your problems. Now, after these words, Vicky gets confidence, and she starts to engage in prostitution, that is to make love for money. Vicky got a lot of money, and in order to silence her uncle, she used it to come with, she used to come with a crate of beer. Sometimes she used to come with cartons of hard drinks. Now, her uncle failed to say anything. Now, that's how Vicky decided to leave. This is what happened in chapter number 4, after coming back to Bunibugyo. And we have seen the mistreatment of Vicky in this family of her uncle. While the children of her uncle was sent to school, Vicky was staying there. Nobody was caring about his education or other needs. That's how live. That means that the girl, these children whom they don't have parents, it's how they are being treated in most of our families. Now, can you try to answer some questions concerning this chapter? Question number 1. What are the effects of peer groups? Referring the Vicky's friends to Sime and Kunihira. What are the effects of peer groups? Question number 2. Which traditions are good and what are bad? We have seen some practices that have been taking place in the previous chapters. Now, can you pick some traditional elements which seem to be good, and those which seems to be bad? Question number 3. If you were given an opportunity to advise Vicky, what would you tell her concerning her life in her uncle's house? Now, if you are given a chance to advise this girl, what would you say? What would you tell her? That is the question. And the last question in this chapter is that, what are the themes discussed in this chapter? Have you got the message concerning the treatment of Vicky in this family? If that is the case, try to analyze this chapter, themes or the message seems to appear in this chapter. That is chapter number 4. Okay, let's continue with another chapter, that is chapter number 5. If you look at the picture, students and viewers, the picture seems, students are singing. primary school students, I mean pupils, are singing. What is going on? Where do they sing? Where do they sing? Now let us see that it's all about chapter number 5. There are students singing, and also there is a man, very tired. He's sitting. Who is that? How can we relate this picture with what we are going to read? Can you predict? There are a lot of students are very happy singing. The man is sitting there, very tired, very lonely. Can you predict what happened? What is going to happen in chapter number 5, students? Okay. In chapter number 5, the man we have seen is Mr. Adieri, the father of 2 children. What is wrong with him? The man is set in the hall of Kinyamasika Primary School, as you have seen the students singing in a Kinyamasika Primary School. This school, this man has been teaching there at Kinyamasika Primary School. Now, he was invited to attend the Parent Day meeting, and it's where you have seen students are singing. The man has been invited there because he was the pioneer teachers of this school. Then what happened, the students? Now, Adieri was very weak. If you look at the man, he seemed to be very weak, very tired. Now, what happened today, I mean to him, what is wrong with him? That's because he seems to be very weak. He was coughing during that day. He was very coughing. He had a frequent fever and vomiting. His hair is very sparse and gray, but his face looked thin like a child's face. And his skin seems to have many rashes. Now, can you predict such person? Maybe what is wrong with that person having these problems? Can you try to predict, dear students? Now, in that day, as you have seen students singing, now the verse within that song, some words seem to hurt, seem to touch this man very much. We have been told that this man was very sick, having these problems, but he was being touched by the words from that song which were being sung by the students you have seen. Now, what are the words? Can you try to predict? To extract some words from these verses? What memories shall I leave when I'm gone? Students are singing like that. What memories shall I leave when I'm gone? If memories I shall leave are only those of having eaten and drunk, I shall be ashamed. There is no honor in that. That is the words from that particular song. The man is listening at this song, and he has seemed to be very much touched with these words. Students were singing a song whose words hurt Adieri. Many people who die in anonymity, that are the words, they die because the glorious things they did were eating, drinking, and sleeping. They crown their glory with death, a deed which is not even for the young on a breast. That is having passed like a shadow. That is the end of this song. Now, some words from this song, it touched this man very much. Now, can you predict maybe, can you try to predict maybe the word? Can you get the time to reason why this man was very touched by these words? Said that doing this thing, maybe spending a lot of time, spending your money, and sometimes not bother to invest something for your future life. If you live in such way, that means at the end of the day, when you die, you will say that you have passed like a shadow. Now, the man was listening very attentive from this song, and he seemed to be very much painful after realizing the meaning of these words. Now, it's from the last verse of this song where the author have derived the title of the book, Pass Like a Shadow. Now, who have passed like a shadow? Let's go on. Since there was nobody to chat, as you have seen, the man sitting there very lonely. Nobody was chatting to him. And Asema, he went back home feeling very rejected. Well, he seemed to be very bored, and he decided to go back home. She was bored with the situation, maybe the words, and sometimes see there was no company. Thereafter, at this time, as you have seen Adieri, he was living alone. We have been told that this man has having a wife with two children and another adopted child, that is Vicky. There are a family of five members. And we are told that the man has abandoned his family. Why? And at this moment, he was living alone. So what is wrong with this man? And we have been told also that he is sick at this moment. The man decided to abandon his family just because he has established a relationship with his secretary when he was teaching, when he was a headmaster of St. Leo's Secondary School, before he was dismissed by the bishop. After being realized that he had love affairs with another employee, that is Secretary Birungi. Now, he decided to abandon his family and he went to live with his secretary Birungi. Now, in that at St. Leo's Secondary School, the man was caught to have financial scandal. He used school money, school fund, to build a house for his concubine Birungi, a woman he shared love. He used it to use a lot of money from the school to build a house for Birungi. Well, there is no house for his family. That is what the man has done. So what happened after that moment, when after the man was chased away, was dismissed from the school, from his work, he decided to sell. He starts to sell his inherited land. There was no property he owned at this moment, because he used to spend money for drinking, eating, and helping his concubine. Now, at that moment where he has no money, he decided to use his inherited land. And the money was used to open the shop for this woman. Nothing. He has done nothing for his family. He neglected his responsibility as a father. Mr. Adieri rejected to take care of his family. Thus, is that his relative, distant cousin, that is Uncle Aradi, decided to take part, that is to help his family in case of education and other needs. But at the same chapter number 5, we have seen Adieri being admitted at the Atibiruka Hospital. He was for the treatment of tuberculosis. The man was sick, and now he was admitted at Viruka Hospital to be treated this problem of tuberculosis. Now, do you remember the problems concerning presence of skin rashes, become very thin, vomiting, the hair seems to be very sparse. If you lose weight And here we have been told that the man is suffering from tuberculosis. Can you guess the problem that the man is having now? Okay, let's go on. The man was told to be infected by HIV/AIDS, the deadly disease, the disease that has no vaccine, no cure. The man has been infected. Now, can you guess what will happen? He used to have several partners. Since the disease can be transmitted, is it transmitted through the exchange of body fluid? Now, the man used to have many partners beside a family, beside Amoti and his concubine Birungi. He used to have other women. While from the hospital, Adieri was chased away by his concubine Birungi, who had been living with another boyfriend. When Adieri was admitted in the hospital, told that he was suffering from tuberculosis and the man has been infected, this girl Birungi decided to take a new boyfriend whom she was living with. Now, after coming back, when the man was, after coming back from the hospital, Mr. Adieri decided to go to Birungi, where the man was chased away by this concubine, just because this woman was living with another man. His wife Amoti was living away in a new house which was built by her son Atoki. The man decided to abandon his family. They were living in very hard condition. The son decided to build the house in order to take care, to accommodate his family, his relative, that his mother and his sister Abuki. There, Adieri starts to leave home very lonely, and we have been told that the man is sick. Nobody was there to take care of her. No food, nobody to help him. That is the life of the main character, Mr. Adieri. His wife, Amoti, was living in a new house. Adieri started to live alone. Thereafter, as you see, the man is living alone. He's very lonely. And we have been told that he is sick. He is infected by HIV/AIDS. But the family, his friends, his concubine, his wife was not there. He was living alone. No food, no what. And at that time, the man cannot do anything. He is very weak. That is chapter number 5. Now, referring this chapter, can you try to attempt this question? Question number 1. What are the symptoms of AIDS victim? Can you try to memorize the symptoms of the HIV/AIDS victim? How a person looks like, how the person looks like when he or she was infected by the virus? Question number 2, many characters suffer in life because of their own past mistakes. Many characters suffer because of their own past mistakes. Discuss this statement with reference to Adieri's life in this chapter. If you refer Adieri's life, we have been told that he was a teacher, headmaster at St. Leo's Secondary School, St. Leo's High School. The man seemed, the man was educated, he was an educated man. How does he live? What happened to him that he's now being infected with HIV by the HIV, you can say HIV or AIDS? That is what happened in chapter number 5. Let's go to chapter number 6. In chapter number 6, what happened there? Atoki is the son of Mr. Adieri. The son of Mr. Adieri. He has completed his high education and become very good and popular popular footballer in the country, that is in Uganda, who was very famous because he used to play football. It's very popular now, known by everybody. He received several awards through football. Atoki received several awards which enabled him to build a house for his mother and sister. We have been told that Amoti was leaving after being abandoned by her husband. He went to live in a new house built by his son, by her son Atoki. Now, how does this boy attempted to build a house? It's through his talent as a footballer. Now, he forgot about his father, Atoki. After being known, he has a lot of money, but he forgot his father, who planned never to ask anything from him. When Mr. Adieri heard that his son is now very famous, has money, but there was no communication with him, he decided to stay silent without asking any assistance from Atoki. Now Atoki is very busy taking care of her, of his mother and his sister. That is chapter number 6. Let's go on. Also, Adieri, he seems to reject his own family. He said that he will never ask any financial assistance from his son Atoki, but also he planned not to receive dowry when this girl, his daughter Abuki, wants to get married. So the man has isolated himself from this family. Amoti, the wife of Mr. Adieri, this woman, used to tell her children that their father's sickness, as the man is being sick, he said that the sickness was a punishment from God. Maybe due to his wrong deeds, he was punished by God. And if that's not the case, maybe the man might have been witched. But we have told that he was identified from the hospital that the man is suffering from HIV virus. And the woman is saying that this man must be bewitched or it's just a punishment from God. He's not aware of this killing disease, this woman. Sometimes she said that sometimes it might be maybe a curse. Maybe he was going against their spirit. Maybe it could be a curse for the wrong deeds that he used to do for his family. That is the perception of Shoti Amoti, wife of Mr. Adieri. This woman was not aware that her husband is infected by AIDS. And for that moment, she might be infected also. She's not aware of that. She's saying that maybe the man was bewitched by somebody. Maybe it's just a punishment from God. No, she knows nothing concerning this HIV AIDS. That's the problem. She was very happy that her husband was rejected by his secretary Birungi, his concubine Birungi. She heard that her husband is living alone just because he was chastened by his concubine, that is a woman he had a relationship with. One day, it's still in chapter number 6, one day, an elderly woman came to beg Amoti to forgive her husband who was suffering alone. We have seen Adieri living alone after being neglected. They've been chased away by his concubine Birungi. He was living alone and we have been told that he's very sick. Now, people, after realizing that the man was isolated by his family, one elderly woman decided to come to his wife Amoti and tell her that, "You Amoti, have a mass, You have a mess on your husband. He's very sick. He's suffering alone. He is in bad condition. Can you try to accept, I mean, to live with him in this house? I'm not rejected. But at the same time, there is no food that the patient can eat. There is no food, nobody to help him, nobody to care for anything. Later on, at the same time, when the elderly woman was still talking to Amoti, a group of people arrived there, carrying Mr. Adieri on a stretcher. As you see, Mr. Adieri is being carried. The man is very sick, is very weak, suffering from tuberculosis, an infected person, is very sick, that he cannot walk. A group of people, some of them are friends of his son Atoki, decided to carry this man to his wife, that is Amoti. So at the same time, when an elderly woman was begging Amoti to forgive her husband, these people arrived carrying Mr. Adieri on a stretcher. Seems that Adieri at this moment cannot walk now. At this moment, his children have seen their father, who was very thin and barely not recognizable. So what happened? Atoki refused and told a woman not to go. And when Amoti was told that you have to forgive your husband, this woman rejected that and said that you just go to Birungi, the woman she was sharing love. So you go there, swear the man has used a lot of money, build a house, funding for for Birungi's shop. So you better go there so that this Mr. Adieri can go to live with Birungi. But it was difficult because this money was chased away by Birungi. That became very difficult. Now, this man, when his wife see him, he was stinking. He was in bad condition. He was stinking. He was stinking and had bad souls. Stinking, that means there was nobody to clean him. So he was stinking sometimes. His mouth involuntarily was, the saliva from his mouth was moving involuntarily. He cannot control the saliva from moving from his mouth. Amoti showed him them the room. This woman, his wife, showed them the room. Go and put this man there. But she was not happy. She was very bitter with the people who brought Mr. Adieri in this house. So Madieri was put in a certain room in this Atoki's house. And this group of people asked Atoki that his son to accept his father despite of the wrong deeds, despite all his past mistakes. At this moment, this man could be healthy, even though he has committed a lot of mistakes. So the people decided to talk to Atoki so that he can accept his father. His children felt sorry for their father and were crying uncontrollably. That is Abuki and Atoki. After seeing his father, their father, they were crying uncontrollably, feeling very sorry for their father. Now, let us see questions that are related to the previous chapter, chapter number 6. What happened to Adieri after he was discharged? After he was discharged from Virika Hospital, where he was admitted for the treatment of tuberculosis. So what happened when he came back? Did Adieri deserve the treatment he got from his children and wife? We have been told the mistreatment he used to do for his family. That means he was not able to take care for his family. Now, the situation you have seen in chapter number 60, that the man deserved to be treated like that by his wife and children. Another question, why is it important to encourage children? Why is it important to encourage children to develop their talents? Students have a lot of talents. You can observe, maybe school children, some of them might be have an ability to sing, sometimes to dance, to do a lot of things. And we seem to encourage them to concentrate on studies, now forgetting their talents. It's what we do several times. Now, the question is being asked, is it important to encourage them to develop their talents, even if they are still doing their studies? That's the question. The last question, what are the themes discussed in this chapter? Have you got the message from this chapter? Now, try to find out the themes from this chapter. That is chapter number 6. The last chapter for today, for this session, is chapter number 7. What happened in chapter number 7? We have been told that Atoki, the son of Mr. Adieri, is now popular for his ability to play football. He's very famous in Uganda. Now, he decided to visit his friend David. Now, here the author is trying to introduce us to a new character, that is David. David is a friend of who? Atoki. They met at a football training camp. They are both footballers. Now, what happened? Atoki told David his plan to go to the university. Now, after completing Form 6, that is high school, Atoki decided to visit his friend David in Kampala. There, he told his friend that he is planning to go to the university, but he was discouraged by David. Why? He discouraged him because he said that the man has now having a lot of money, he can do anything. He has attempted maybe to build a house for his family, for his mother and his sister. He has a lot of money and he's capable to play football. Now, why bother? Why wasting time going to the university? Now, his friend David convinced Atoki not to go to the university. He can live because he has a lot of money. And something that he can enjoy most is having love affairs with the girls. Something that is very new to Atoki. He was being told by his friend David. When he was trying to convince his friend David, he said that he was trying to quote the Bible in a wrong way. He said that God told people to enjoy the fruits of the earth. And for that matter, he is referring the fruits of the earth as girls. So as a man having a lot of money, you can enjoy the fruits of the earth. You can enjoy your life by having relationship, by changing these girls. He said that there is nothing sweeter than having love affairs with the girls. That is how he was trying to quote the Bible wrongly so that he can convince his friend Atoki, who seems to be afraid of having relationship just because there is a disease that is HIV. Now let's see what happened. At first, he tried to avoid the girl's temptation. He was confused very much by his friend, but he was trying. Since he was still living in Kampala, he was trying to avoid these temptations of the girls. The girls themselves tried to invite the boys to establish a relationship. Now he tried very much. He was afraid to be infected as his father. But later on, he engaged himself in love affairs. Now, what happened? That Atoki engaged in love affairs. David used to tell Atoki that you cannot be infected if you take much precaution. If you take a proper precaution, that means if you use condoms in a proper way, if you were very much care in picking the girls, looking at the girls like, just by using your eyes, and if you look at the girl, you can be able to pick the girl that is not infected. Is it possible, my dear students? That is what happened to Atoki. He was told to be very much careful, if to use condoms sometimes, if to be very much careful in picking the girls, just by looking, just knowing the background of the girls, you can avoid this infection. That's true. This is, we have seen Atoki, we have seen Atoki with a girl. Who is that girl? That is Atoki was sitting relaxing with a girl, a beautiful girl. Who is that? We have been told that he was trying to avoid their temptations. The girls, since the man was very famous, many girls was admiring to establish a relationship with this man. But the man was afraid, just from Kachamba, where he has witnessed his father dying of HIV and the condition he had suffered. He was afraid of this deadly disease. But now he has moved to Kampala. He was advised, he was convinced to establish a relationship with girls. Now that is the situation. Who is that girl? One day, Atoki and his friend Adebi, they have gone to the Sheraton Hotel. Now, it's where Atoki tested alcohol for the first time. As we know how the alcohol works. And that's the situation. The man was sitting with a girl. He was taking alcohol. What happened? We know how this thing works. When somebody takes alcohol, what happened to his mind? This woman was trying to win Atoki so that he can, he can love affairs with her. He attempted to kiss Atoki in public. And she always sat in a provocation, careless posture, wearing these short clothes, tight clothes, just to attract Atoki. David assured Atoki that this woman, whom we have introduced, she's called Ada. David assured that this Ada is safe just because he's a public relation officer. The woman she was talking, he was sitting with, is a public relation officer. That David is telling that this woman, just because he's a government employee, she's not infected, she's safe. Now you can establish a relationship with her and you cannot be infected. David, Atoki's friend was living with his father at Makindye. But his father was a very important person. There was no mother in this house. So only two people were living, a son with his father. This father, whom we have been told is an important person in the government, he used to chat with the girls. He was changing girls. Now, despite he knows, but this man knows the truth concerning HIV/AIDS. He said that people who are giving education concerning AIDS, that means people have to protect themselves. He said that these people are old-fashioned ones. So he forgot about it then. He likes to watch pornography. That is the habit of this man in order to encourage, in order to arouse sexual desire. David likes his father. David likes his father, the behavior of his father. He said that my father is very good at picking girls. That means the man used to change girls. And he was very good in selecting the girls. That is the behavior of David's father. And their talk is there. One day at talk at the Sheraton Hotel, when he tasted beer for the first time, that alcohol I was talking about, he remembered the girl he was sitting with, that is Ada. We have been told it's a public relation officer. Now, after tasting alcohol, I have told you, if you tasted this thing for the first time, your mind could change. So can you think, can you try to reason what happened to Atoki? He just tasted beer for the first time. At the same time, he tried to remember Ada, a woman who loves him. David tried to connect Atoki with this girl, and they attempted to spend several nights in the visitor's quarter, that is in David's house. There was visitor's quarter. So the girl, this Ada, was invited to go there, and he spent several nights with Atoki. That means Atoki was born. So what happened to Atoki? That is, we'll see it in the next chapter. That is all about chapter number 7. Now, can you try to attempt this question? Question number 1. What does Ada represent? We know that Ada is a public relations officer. He's at the Sheraton Hotel seeking for lovers. Now, what does this woman represent? Example, question number 2. Explain how David's father helped it to ruin, to destroy, to change the behavior of his son. We have heard the story of David's father, an important person in the government, but he used it to change the girls, good at picking girls. He's living with his son alone. Now, can you explain how this father helped me to ruin the behavior of his son David? That is the question. Question number 3, how do people's life change when they go away from home? As we have seen, Atoki from Kachomba village, where he was afraid of AIDS, when he goes to Kampala, now we have seen the lifestyle has changed. Now you are asking me to explain how people's lives change when they go away from home. That is all about chapter number 7. May I invite you to attend another session that I'm going to give. I will continue to give. To give a brief summary of the of the 3 remaining chapters before we start analyzing the book, Past the Like a Shadow. Thank you very much for watching.